Hi everyone, and welcome to this video, once again, featuring the legendary Mac Pro 4.1 or 5.1. In this video, I'll cover running macOS Sonoma on this machine. We will take a look at how we can accomplish running the latest macOS version on this relatively old and out-of-support hardware, and we'll see if everything is functional and performing well with two different GPUs, as this turned out to be an issue on Ventura in an earlier video. I do know that Sonoma has been released for quite some time now, and it has been possible to get it running on this classic Mac Pro for a while as well. I just didn't find the time yet to go through this, but thought this still might be interesting. The machine that I will use for this video is my trusty, lightly damaged, but still functional, Mac Pro 4.1. In earlier videos, for which I will provide a link in the description in case you would be interested, I already flashed it to a 5.1, upgraded the CPUs, installed an NVMe drive, upgraded the GPU, and brought the machine to the latest available bootrom version. I had it on macOS Ventura and even Windows 11 for quite some time, but here I'll start again with the latest officially supported version for this machine, which is macOS Mojave. And to get that installed, I had to put back the AMD Radeon HD7950, which provides metal. Later in the video, I'll replace this card with this RX580, which didn't perform very well in Ventura last time I tried, so I'm curious to see if this got improved now with newer versions of the OCLP root patches. To upgrade the OS, or as I will do, perform a fresh install of Sonoma, we'll be using OpenCore Legacy Patcher. I've been through this process a few times before and also documented this extensively in a separate video. We need this as it allows you to run the latest macOS versions on hardware that Apple declared obsolete and unsupported, as is the case for this machine for quite a while now. As that's been covered before, I'll not go into too much detail on that process, but rather focus on the specifics for this machine. As you can see, after all these previous upgrades and changes, the Mac Pro I have now is equipped with two 3.06 GHz 6-core Intel Xeon CPUs, also known as X5675. It has 24 GB of DDR3 memory in triple channel and that AMD Radeon HD7950 as GPU. Current bootrom version is the latest and greatest, 144.0000. Now, in terms of drives, the installed version of macOS Mojave is booted from the SSD that's present in the second SATA slot here, a Gutram CX400 of 256 GB. And our goal is to install Sonoma on the drive that is present in the first slot, a PNI C900 SSD of 250 GB. To accomplish this, we'll need a USB drive as well. The first step will be to prepare that USB drive with the Sonoma installer and OpenCore. So we can then use it to boot the Sonoma installer through OpenCore and get Sonoma and later OpenCore as well on that drive in slot 1. As I mentioned, it's theoretically possible to upgrade the current installed version of macOS Mojave to Sonoma, but this doesn't always work flawlessly in my experience, and it brings some extra complications as the currently installed GPU does not show us a boot screen. Instead, I will use Mojave to prepare the USB drive, then remove that SSD with Mojave, which will force the system to boot from the USB drive, as it will be the only bootable drive available in the system. Let's get started, and the first step is to prepare those drives that I just mentioned. Once the machine has booted, let's start Disk Utility and click on View Show All Devices to make sure we can see which volume is where exactly. The first one in the list is the drive in the first slot where we plan on installing Sonoma. Second in the list is where we have Mojave running from right now. Although we can do this later, let's prepare the target drive first. I'll use APFS and call it Sonoma for clarity. Now, let me also prepare the USB drive. Which we can see here. Let's prepare that one as well and call it Sonoma install. There we go. Next, we need to download OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And straight away, you get a good reason to upgrade to a newer macOS version. With Safari that came with Mojave, I'm no longer able to download any files from GitHub. And also, when earlier I was trying to download Chrome instead, Safari couldn't even start that download, but fortunately, I did manage to install Firefox on here, and although we can't run the latest version on here as well, at least we can use it to download OCLP from GitHub. In OCLP, we first need to download the Sonoma installer. And as you can see, after we selected Sonoma in the list, we're getting a warning message here that the keyboard and or mouse might not be available during installation. I'll come back to that when we get there, but for now we can just choose to download anyways. The installer is quite large, so this might take a while, depending on your download speed. Once downloaded, validated, and extracted, we can then use the installer now and write the required data to the USB drive. This takes quite some time again, this time depending on the write speed of the USB drive. When everything is copied and verified, we can then proceed to build OpenCore specifically for this machine and install the build on that USB drive as well. So again, first drive here is currently running Mojave, the second is our target drive, and the third is the USB drive. This is where we now want to install OpenCore at this stage. Our USB installer is ready now. We will not reboot the system, but instead I will shut down the machine. Then, as I mentioned, I will remove the second drive here, which has Mojave on it, and boot up the Mac. As its non-boot drive, that second SSD, is no longer present in the system, this will force it to search for other bootable drives, which is our USB drive. If our GPU would support a boot screen, we wouldn't need to do this and could just hold Alt or Option on the keyboard to display a boot picker, but we can't see that now. If all goes well, we should get to see OpenCore after a bit of patience. Here it is, and let's select the single available option, Install macOS Sonoma. This boots up the installer from the USB drive. After it's loaded, if you still remember when we were downloading Sonoma with OCLP earlier, we got warned for a known issue on this specific Mac Pro related to not having a keyboard and mouse during installation. And that's exactly what we're seeing here. The workaround for that, as is documented on OCLP's GitHub, is to use a USB hub rather than directly connecting your keyboard and mouse to the machine. After a small amount of waiting, I still managed to get through to the language selection of the installer, and in my case, to my surprise actually, the Apple keyboard that I'm using seems to work fine. Only the mouse did not get detected. As this Apple keyboard has a built-in USB hub with ports on either side, I guess the keyboard is going through that hub as well. That definitely makes sense and explains why this is working. When connecting the mouse through the keyboard as well, this solved the issue completely for me. But as we could see, if this would not work for you, use a USB hub to connect the keyboard and mouse instead of directly to the machine. In that earlier video which I mentioned for Ventura, that's exactly what I did. Now that we managed to overcome this issue, all we need to do is to click Install macOS Sonoma. There is no need to go through disk utility as we prepared our drives beforehand from Mojave, so let's continue here. Select the prepared drive, and once again, we're up for quite a bit of waiting. About 45 minutes later, in my case, we are greeted with the setup dialog of macOS Sonoma. Let us quickly click ourselves through here. There we go, that went pretty fluent actually, and it looks like we finally get macOS Sonoma running on our Mac Pro 4.1 or 5.1, very nice to see. As we get informed by OpenCore, we are still booting the system using the USB drive, So now we need to rebuild OpenCore again and install it to our SSD now instead. This time, we need to select the internal drive here in slot 1 as destination. Let us test straight away if this works as expected now by removing the USB drive and performing a reboot. That looks promising. We can see OpenCore. And Sonoma seems to boot up just fine as well, using only the SSD in the first slot. At first glance, things seem to work exactly as expected. We can also see in OCLP that all root patches have been applied already during the installation. About this Mac shows us exactly what we expected. The hardware matches, and indeed, we are running the latest version of macOS Sonoma. Let me quickly run some benchmarks now. I ran both GPU and compute benchmarks in Geekbench 5 and 6, just as I did on Ventura about a year ago on the same hardware. We've got all the results, so let's compare the numbers and see if a newer OS has any impact on performance. For Geekbench 5, we can see a slight improvement over macOS Ventura previously. And also for compute, we're getting about the same result as we had on Ventura. For Geekbench 6, we can see similar numbers, a very small improvement in CPU performance, and as good as the same number for compute. All in all, these differences are very small, so my conclusion would definitely be that performance is exactly the same as it was on Ventura, and even more, exactly the same as on Windows 11 as well. Looks like we got Sonoma working as expected. Let's see now if we can upgrade that HD7950 to the RX580, which should perform better in theory. I'll start by removing the HD7950. Now, before we can install the other card, we'll need to replace the PCIe power cables. The RX580 has an 8-pin power connector instead of 2x6-pin. With this cable, we can convert the 2x mini PCIe connectors on the motherboard to exactly what we need. There we go. Let's insert that RX580 now and connect it to that single 8-pin power connector. Looking good. Let's see if we can boot the system. OpenCore seems to come up. That's good, and macOS starts booting. Oh, but it looks like we are suddenly getting a blank screen, and it looks like the fans of the RX580 stopped as well. That can never be good. I realized that I didn't revert the root patches before changing the video card, so I thought that this was the cause of this behavior. Let me swap back to the old card again. There we go. And now let's boot the system. This still seems to work fine, so let's start OCLP and revert the installed root patches. Here we are, attempt number 2 to swap the card. Unfortunately, the behavior seems to be the same as before. We can see OCLP, and then the first part of the macOS boot process looks fine, but eventually the screen goes blank. After some troubleshooting and some reading, I came across this thread on Reddit. Although this is with Monterey, it seems to be exactly the issue what I'm experiencing. The steps here suggest that rebuilding and reinstalling OpenCore with the correct GPU present should fix the issue. as I can't seem to get into Sonoma at all with this GPU to do this, even without the root patches installed, I decided to put back the drive with Mojave in slot 2 and disconnect the Sonoma drive. To force the system to set its default boot drive to the Mojave SSD in slot 2, I'll do a PRAM reset. That means holding the keys Command, Option, P and R simultaneously at boot until you hear the chime a second time. If I would not do this, I could boot into Mojave with only that drive present, but as soon as I would reinsert the Sonoma drive, the system would prefer that one, and I need both of the drives active and Mojave to boot up by default. Okay, as I hoped, Mojave managed to boot up fine with this GPU, so let's shut down the system again, reinsert the Sonoma drive, and boot once more. If all goes well, we should again end up in Mojave, because that's now our default drive. But this time, we also have the Sonoma drive in slot 1 available. Okay, looks like that worked exactly as I want. From Mojave, we can start OCLP now and rebuild OpenCore and then reinstall it to the drive that has Sonoma, which is disk 1 here. Our reboot brings me again to Mojave, of course, so I will need to disconnect that drive with Mojave and boot again. If all of this works, I'll eventually do another PRAM reset, just as I did before, with only the Sonoma drive, so we will by default always prefer that drive. Let's first see if this workaround has helped. Okay, we're getting OpenCore, and that first part of loading macOS as well. The screen does go blank again, but it doesn't seem to drop the signal as I can see on the monitor this time. Alright, here we go. Seems this is working. Nice. We do notice right away that without any patches, Sonoma is definitely struggling quite a bit, so let's get these installed using OpenCore first. All done, and let's do another reboot. I kind of lost count, honestly. Okay, finally, after quite a bit of struggling and a lot of reboots, we got here where we want, and I have Sonoma running on my classic Mac Pro using an AMD Radeon RX580. At first glance, at least in macOS, everything seems to work pretty fluent actually. Looks like Wi-Fi is working fine as I can find all the networks in the neighborhood. And the same thing applies for Bluetooth. I can see my phone, so things are working exactly as we want them to. So let's rerun those compute benchmarks with Geekbench 5 and 6 and now compare the performance with that HD7950 and what we got earlier on Ventura with the RX580, which was not performing as expected. Here are the results, and as you can see, they are a bit strange. For the compute test in Geekbench 5, we get a better result compared to the older version of OpenCore Legacy Patcher and Ventura, but still, the result is less good than with HD7950, which shouldn't be the case, and that clearly shows by the number I got on the same machine on Windows 11. For Geekbench 6, it's even weirder. We're getting an even worse result now compared with the same card on Ventura. And although it does score better than the HD7950 in this test, it doesn't come close to its full potential, which again we seem to get only on Windows. Too bad to see this, and unfortunately the conclusion I got from the earlier videos stays the same. For gaming and maximum graphical performance, it looks like Windows is still the best choice on the system, how weird it may sound. It does support a wider range of GPUs and other hardware, and even then, they perform better than under macOS. Nevertheless, it's not like this machine, even with an RX580, can be called anywhere near slow. Especially for productivity tasks, it's still great, or for games that require a bit less GPU power, like Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, for example, this beauty still does a great job. That was it for the video. Thanks a lot for watching. As always, if you have liked this video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments how your experience with Sonoma on this hardware is, or if you have any questions. And if you like these kinds of videos, make sure to subscribe to not miss anything. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.